abnormal molar mass is continued, what will happen to the molar mass of the solute if it is dissociated in the polar solvent? That we are going to see now. In the previous video we saw about association, now we will saw about dissociation. So this is regarding to dissociation of solute. Supposing a solute is dissolved in a polar solvent. Polar solvent contains high dielectric constant. Example water. So what would happen? Instead of association, you will get dissociation. For example, if you take any solute electrolyte AB, this will give A plus and B minus, cation and anion. So one solute particle will give two particles, two ions or two particles in the dielectric solvent which contains high dielectric constant. Consequently, total number of molecules in the solution, will be, here it is 1, here it is 2. After you add it in the solution, it becomes 2. Therefore, colligative properties of such molecules will be almost higher. In this case, once again, because colligative property depends upon the number of particles of the solute. So, for example, if the colligative property here is doubled and therefore molar masses is inversely proportional, so therefore molar masses is inversely proportional to colligative property, molar masses will be one half of the theoretical value. Therefore, for example, if you take critical example of sodium chloride. If you take sodium chloride, will be ionized into Na plus and Cl minus. Its actual molar mass is 58.5. But what will happen? Due to dissociation, the colligative properties will increase. Therefore, exactly the molar masses, the molar mass of sodium chloride will be lowered. Lowering of molar mass, it will be exactly 29.25. So this abnormal molar mass is happening due to dissociation of solute in polar solvents. This is known as abnormal molar mass concept due to dissociation of solute.